my first two novels were big books, Mating and Mortals the Second, and they were both set in Africa. Presently, I lived in Africa from 78 with my wife, from 78 to 83, and that was the basis for both of the African books. We lived in Botswana. And two novels, one very considerable, and my first one, Mating, which was the one that won the National Book Award, was what allowed me to continue with writing, because I was actually beginning to publish in a serious way when I was in my late 40s. In any case, those books were very life-consuming, and when we had returned from Africa, I decided that I wanted to write about America, which I found as strange as any country I had been in, as it had evolved in the 5 years that we were away. And I wanted to write about the evolution of the political medium in which people were living their lives. The thing that I like to do in my novels is to take a familiar kind of diagram, like in the case of Mating, it was boy meets girl. In the case of Mortals, also set in Africa, it is a triangle. And in this case, it was about friendship and reunion, like a 20 years after reunion of childhood, young manhood friends, in the context of the death of one of them. They are all tending to be moving into their 50s. One of them has at last, after a long, unhappy, unproductive relationship, been found by a woman who wants to marry him, and he wants to marry, and he's on the verge of consummating that relationship. And they all come together at this place in the Catskills, where a wealthy and kind of interesting friend of theirs has recently died in an accidental death. And everyone's lives have been interrupted by this, and what was interrupted in the case of the male narrator is preparations for a massive march against the impending war in Iraq, which everyone, I mean, in their part of the world was opposed to. So anyway, there's a gathering and the unwinding of many secrets from the past, and the attempt to bring out of the past and into the present the kinds of feeling of friendship among men, because I had developed the feeling that there wasn't much writing about male friendship in modern novels. From a deep distance, it is comical that people are trying to change their fates so energetically in such challenging and unprofitable looking circumstances. And there are two things. There's the comic view of life and there's the tragic view of life. This is not Unamuno, this is something else. It's closer to Cervantes and a European comic tradition than it is anything sort of slapstick. It's a comedy related to pathos. And one of the interesting things about the book is that everybody are finally drawn together out of the various kinds of lethargy or distraction into the signing the petition against the war. And when the march finally occurs, it's an enormous success internationally. The attempt to stop the war, if it had been based on the numbers only, that of that mobilization, it should have stopped the war. But it has turned out to be a truly a shameful thing for American history, that the war was a war of choice, and that the consequences in terms of lives lost has been enormous, and it is still going on. The consequences today. I mean, it's like an open sore still. And it's not necessarily the kind of thing that Americans want to be reminded about. There was some, in the reviews of the book in the United States, there was clearly some uneasiness around a resistance to taking up the topic. But there are things in the lives of nations, all empires of one kind or another do terrible things, but there are sometimes individual episodes or events which stand out and which have to be overcome in a certain way or dealt with in a certain way, and literature encompasses those events. I mean, if you think in France, for example, just to be at random almost, as you have the Sétif massacre in 1945, or you have the Épuration, where nobody has, there is no great novel in French about the Épuration that I know of. And but these things stick really in the historical memory and demand some kind of resolution, attention. And that's, for the US, there's plenty of terrible stuff in the past, My Lai, the Phoenix program in Vietnam, there's plenty of dishonorable events, but this is a classic, and it's still hurting. Yeah, it's the role of the writers to give an honest witness and to bring into memory those things which if you take yourself seriously as a citizen of a culture, of a country, of a tradition, to bring those things into life. Well, I'll talk about a book by a young fellow named Joshua Cohen called The Book of Numbers, which is a new book, a big book. He's still in his 30s. We've been working on it for years, and it is an attempt to capture in literature the effect of the internet in life and in relations between the most compelling technological change in the way we live and the environment in which we live is the dawning of the internet into in this tentacular way, and it's continuing evolution. It's quite a brilliant book, and it's the first really substantial capture of this change so large that we fail to see it or to comprehend it or to make sense of it.